Meet Drake, I can backpack it.
Good.
Anything else you want to talk about 2K related?
I'm super excited for the new game. I love the covers. I love that like D-Book has his shoe like kind of like the focal point in it, and it says Be Legendary, and I think he's a legend, just signed like a crazy extension. I love like the women's cover, love the Michael Jordan cover. You might see some Circulate in the new game. Super excited for that, and yeah, like shout out to the whole 2K family, and thank you for always having me be a part.
MOT Jamar, live online under the game NBA 2K22. The uptime begins.
Hello, it's China Mac.
What are you excited about for this year's game?
Well, for the first time, I got my face scan.
Yeah.
So I guess
UK Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
Game 7. Mini Drake, I can backpack it.
Six, forget a stretch five. My teammates loved it.
Stretch six. I love that. Great stuff, David. Thank you. So let's take a look at the Boston Celtics starting lineup. Out in the front court along with Tatum. And it's Young. And there's Jared Allen. And it's Best in at the point guard position. And for the Pistons, they've got Sexton. He's out there with Cunningham. And it's Harden in at the five. You take a look at the Pistons. Greg, this is what you work for all season long. You have Game 7 on your home floor.
Yes, and you have to take advantage. The fans can only do so much, and they've got to be the aggressors and play like there is no tomorrow.
Pass to Howard. Over in the corner, Cunningham. And there's the pass to Sexton. 6 on the shot clock. Basket, good.
You know, not to ask him about positioning himself inside. Sexton knows he has what it takes to score from there.
Passes it to Allen. Kick out to Brown. Here's Best. Pass to Tatum. And a foul called on Kate Cunningham. That is his first foul of the game.
That's something you hate. You're trying to come in with an aggressive mindset, and that early foul could take you right out of it.
Pass to Best. Free throw line jump shot, and no good that time. The Pistons go the other way with it. They come off the loss on Friday.
You know what? That's a game where the coach might just want to burn the video, because there's no question they're a better team than what we saw, but they got crushed on that night.
And obviously, we know that's not how they usually play, but hey, they've got to perform better next time around.
The Pistons shooting their first free throws of the game.
winner goes to the finals.
And the first one at the line is good. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
Allen outside. He dishes it to Tatum. Back to Allen. To the middle. And the rejection by Harden. To the paint. Here's Sexton. His shot is good, making the first
cut
from the floor.
Good way to start this game. You want to get him rolling as early as possible. And we know once he gets in the rhythm, he's a...
Are
really
you serious?
Such a force as Allen goes to the line. A real throwback. Jared is a center who primarily operates near the hoop.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Ability and is just a natural talent down low.
He doesn't get the second one. The Pistons with a quick start to this game. Harden scanning the floor.
There we go.
Oh, and the lead gets bigger on a ridiculous offensive sequence.
That dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop. Now, here's Brown. The pass to Tatum for the three. Boston again missing. For Detroit, they've gotten their first three shots to go in for to start off this game. The Pistons working the ball around now. Cunningham with it. He's against Allen. Here's Harden.
Here we go.
Two free throws coming up.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
For Detroit, they've gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line. Free throw is good. And that's good as he hits both of the shots. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Here's Best. Down low, and it's Allen with the jam.
At 6'11", Allen, a legitimate threat to finish through the rim, especially when given that kind of position.
Now, here's Cunningham. About 3 minutes into this first quarter. stolen away. The layup off target. Celtics trail by 7. Pass passes to Young. They find Jay on the way.
They are out of rhythm. 1 for 5 so far. You just need to calm down and reward your matchup.
Let's take another look at the Stars defense during that Mobile One block.
And well, they didn't make it this far by giving up easy ones. And now the defense is in overdrive.
For Boston, they've gone just 1 for 5 from the field to start the quarter. This is lead by 7. Sexton, the pass to Harden. And Harden hits a shot.
Sexton has to just keep developing his court awareness. You want to see more passing from him.
Passes it to Allen. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, Tatum hits to Allen. Clock at 6. Shoots from 12. Bests.
How the hell did he cross you up like that?
I mean, he is too good with that crossover.
Cunningham dishes it to Harden. To the inside. Sexton ejected by Young. Now Tatum. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. They get it back. And it's Allen slamming it down.
A superb offensive rebounder. Allen's long arms and feel for how to get positioning helps big time.
Howard, the pass to Harden. Here's Steele. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
Hard to create space in that mid-range area. He would have been better passing that off.
Tatum's shot is off. Pistons leading by 5. And here's Cunningham. Over Best. Eyes again. And Harden with the layup.
Let's go.
Salvage the possession. He's a terrific offensive rebounder.
And now the first time out home here for Boston.
And just trying to get some traction offensively. Boy, it hasn't been pretty.
You know, this is a good time to maybe switch up your strategy a little bit. You can't keep doing what you're doing and expect a different result.
Detroit, 7-point differential. After Reed. Avdija with it. 5 to shoot. Rebounded by the Pistons. Harden's got 6 rebounds in the game. Inside. One goes in for him too, making it look easy. He's now 4 for 4.
And it just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
Pass to Macy. Here's Water. Now here's Avdija. Kicks it to Young. Boston needs to get off a shot. It's up a 3. That one's no good. 0-1 to begin the game.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
This is what we talk about. Value in each possession. Avoiding those kinds of mistakes.
We've got 1:48 left to play here in the first. They can use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need the basket.
Here we go. And it's slammed in by Young.
And way to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
Yeah, but look at the basket guy still shaking. Now the pass to Harden. And the jam by Harden. And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. And here is Macy. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Pass to Avia. Fires for three. Rebound, Detroit. Outside, Lamb. Here's Ayton. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Celtics trail by nine. There's 48 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Here's Water. Pass to Macy. Throws it up high.
And hard to decide which is better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
Oh, there's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. Harden dishes to Ayton. Back to Harden. Young with the steal. And the foul on Harden. That'll be his second foul of the game.
The question is, do you leave him in? Obviously, you don't want him to pick up a third foul this early.
Celtics trail by seven. Now Macy. Seconds left, and the layup is up and in.
Now, how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
And that does it for the first quarter. Pistons ahead, up by five. After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on 2K Sports. Now, we know that Colin Sexton is an efficient scorer. He shed some light on the mentality that's made him successful.
I feel like I've just been calm and letting the game come to me and not trying to force anything. And just getting shots that my teammates create for me and just knocking them down.
And even though he's more a point guard in stature, Greg Sexton more of a flat-out scorer at that point than he is a facilitator.
Yeah.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alden.
Well, guys, Silk in the last outing against the Celtics was outstanding. He scored 28 points, and as he always seems to do, piled up rebound after rebound. His numbers were off the charts. He was unguardable, and he knew it. He took advantage of it. Kevin, back to you.
Excellent, David. Thank you. Greg, how impressive was it watching him completely take over?
Unstoppable. They won that game because of his effort and just his overall relentlessness.
That's what every player has control of, his level of activity. It allows you to impact the game even if the shot isn't falling.
That move, you'll see very few players able to pull off. Just sensational stuff.
Outside Tatum. And so it's going to be a 3-second violation out there on the defense.
Yeah, he got me on that one.
In a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Celtics.
They didn't need any time to warm up from long range today. Their three-point shooting has been terrific in the first half. And that's what's created a rhythm for them offensively. That's also why you see them knocking down that mid-range jump shot.
Here career's best. 12 points for him. Locked up there for Allen. Another miss. Boy, they had their chance there, but couldn't get it to go. Sexton, the pass to Cunningham. Here's Best. The Celtics working the ball around now. Got a piece of it. Stolen by Harden. Pass to Howard. Sexton against Brown. It's out of bounds. The Pistons able to retain possession here. Detroit making a switch. Lamb's checked in. Celtics also with a sub. Reed's checked in. Harden outside. He kicks it to Cunningham. Shot clock at six. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far. And he makes the first.
And getting to the line and hitting your free throws, a good way to get back into the game. It stops the clock and extends the game and allows you the opportunity to set your defense. They've been perfect from the line so far here in the second quarter.
And so Cunningham nails both of them. Boston leading by 3. Best passes to Reed. Over Harden. And the rejection by Harden.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
With the tip. And stolen by Tatum. There's a minute 47 left to play here in the half. To the left wing. Livingston, the pass to Reed. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more visible.
This is his first free throw of the game. And that one falls for Reed. So he makes 1 of 2 as the second one misses. Pistons trailed by 4 to the right side. There's the lob to Harden. And that basket was going to count. Goaltending, the official call.
Wow. And how about the incredible timing on that alley-oop?
He absolutely hammered it down. .133 left to play here in the second quarter. Pass to Reed. Here's Livingston. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Passes it to Best for 3. Throws it from outside. And the Celtics lead by 5.
Riding the hot hand. And why not? If something's working, keep going to it.
There's a minute left here in the second. Here's Harden. And that one barely misses. It draws contact. 2 free throws coming up.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
He'll take his 3rd and 4th free throw shots at the game right here. Good from Harden. Javier checked in for Jason Tatum. Both good from the line that time. 56 seconds left now here in the second. Pass to Avdija. Rebounded by Lamb.
Out of character for him to miss that shot. Maybe just a little too casual there.
He finds Sexton. Shoots over Reed. Here's Harden. And that's a nice reward for his effort. The flush. Perfect.
Working hard, beating everyone to the ball. He does this night in and night out.
11 seconds left to play in the first half. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's the 3. And again, Boston with the triple.
And guys, he's been a one-man air raid. Coming at them time and time again.
Yeah, the defense has allowed him to get into a rhythm from there, and he's been relentless.
And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Celtics lead by 4, and we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Double-double going into halftime. That'll pull us out. For Detroit, baby.
And we're back courtside at Game 7 as this series comes to a head.
Six to two, 3 points.
Boston leading by 4. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. On the court for the Pistons, we got Silk. Cunningham is out there with Sexton. And it's Howard in at the 3. Here's Harden on the wing. Ten shots, and yes, it's good. Harden's got the first basket of the second half. That one, pretty close.
At the end of the day, when the ball goes up, there's no substitute for effort.
Here's Bass. Tatum with it. Now defended by Cunningham. Tatum's shot is off. And for the Pistons, they're shooting 47% from the floor, getting it done. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. We'll have a jump ball. And now, let's revisit that exceptional Mobile One block.
And that block was something. It's the playoffs, and every possession and defensive stop matters.
So it's the Pistons now to the left side wing. Outside Howard. A rebound by Young. And here's Young. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. The lead is 2. It's Allen, top of the key. Over Harden. That one a little long.
They come out ice cold to start this half. 3 misses and as many as...
There you go.
The Pistons haven't made a mistake at the line yet. 10 of 10.
Shoot 2.
Yeah. and the first one drops. Ayton, he's checked in for Detroit. And a change for the Celtics. Waters has checked in. And that one drops. He ties it up. Tatum down low. Ayton's there. Some solid defense from Ayton.
They just don't have it right now. 0-4. Must have been one four steep at halftime.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
There's Sexton. And that one drops for him.
No.
Sexton's got two.
Sexton is slightly undersized. He plays with great physicality. Good pressure.
Best passes to Tatum. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Takes the 12-footer and hits. Tatum's got it all tied up now for the Celtics.
This is why you're trying to get him as many touches as possible. He's got the knack.
Harden kicks to Cunningham. Back to Harden. Count that bucket.
He's been a big factor in their offense tonight, making shot after shot.
Outside Tatum. A three-pointer, no good.
But still, eventually you gotta feel like he'll start knocking those down.
Young with the steal. And pushing it up. Here's Boston. Pulls up for three. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
That'll be
Brown's got three assists in the game.
And the skills of Brown, not just a super athlete, but a tremendous floor general as well.
And now the first timeout called here for Detroit.
And they've been very loose with the ball here. They haven't been as patient, forcing things a bit, which has led to turnovers. They need to just slow down and relax.
And the Celtics making a change here. Pistons have gone 3-6 in the third quarter. 50% from the field. Pass to Lawrence. Back to Galloway. The pass to Ayton. Count it. Ayton's got seven.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint.
Approach has been going here so far for the Pistons.
Anytime you get as many points from the paint as they have, you know you've got a good thing going.
Yeah, and the other thing that they've done well is they've really attacked the gaps of the defense with quick, decisive drives down the lane.
Celtics trail by four. Young taking his time here. Now, here's Avdija. 5 points in the game. Just five on the clock. Shoots it up. The rebound by Harden. Harden's got his 16th rebound on the night.
And I wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the backboard.
Now, here's Avdija. He's guarded closely. Now Young. 8 points for him. Passes to Best. Beyond the arc. They'll hit that one. And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively as we approach the fourth quarter. The Pistons on top. They lead by four. And we're coming right back after this break to get the fourth quarter underway. And how about a look now at our assist of the game? Brought to you by State Farm.
And how about the floor generalship right here? I mean, showing us why they're always in good hands when he's the man in charge.
So many good point guards in this league. So much responsibility comes with that position. That was a smart, smart play.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. We've got Avdija. He's out there with Allen, and it's Best in at the point. Howard, the pass to Sexton. And a miss there on the triple. Celtics trail by four. Pass to Brown. Here's Best, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
Shoot through the box.
First free throw is good. So he gets them both. And it's Cunningham with the ball for the Detroit Pistons to the paint. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's on Jared Allen.
At the line, we go Pistons.
Shoot two.
And that one misses. And he's good on the second. Celtics trail by three. Best passes to Reed. Dishes it to Brown. Back to Reed. And he throws it down hard with one hand.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
At the line for Detroit.
Mind the lane. Mind the lane.
One shot.
We go drop for Harden. Celtics trail by four. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter. And it's Allen with the jam.
And you can see Allen's eyes light up when he saw the opportunity for that alley-oop and finishing it off in style.
Cunningham kicks to Sexton. Now the feed to Hart. Goes back up. And the layup ball. Harden's got 12 points here in the second half.
These are big buckets. He's been instrumental in helping them try to close out this game.
Allen outside. It's to Reed. Good work there as a coach. Reed's got 4 points in the quarter.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
Outside, Sexton. Here's the pass to Howard. Back to Sexton. To the middle. Here's Harden. That one doesn't drop. Excellent D there from Allen. Now, here's Obdia. Started by Howard. Pass, pass is out. And here we go. Fast break. Cunningham's got it. It is now to Hardman. Picked away. To take the lead. Obdia gets the bucket. And the Celtics lead by one. And a chance now to catch up on some numbers with the hustle stats for the Celtics.
They've been playing such pesky defense. It's been very impressive, especially all the turnovers they've called.
Yeah, and another thing, they've created a lot of turnovers, but they've also been able to convert when they've gotten out of the transition.
And Allen swings it
in. Focus from Allen, just powering through the physical defense and finding a way to score.
Austin making a switch here. Tatum's checked in, and that one falls for Allen.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
Pistons trail by four. Cunningham passes to Sexton. To the inside, stolen by Obdia. Passes it to Best. Over Cunningham. Best can't hit. For Detroit, they've gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter. So they are 2 of
4. Let's go!
And I just love it when the fast break results in a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
Tatum, that's for two. And good!
And I'll tell you what, Tatum is proving to be an all-around scorer of the basketball. He can do it all.
Steele passes to Howard. Down low, here's Cunningham. Obdia with the rebound. Obdia's got four rebounds now tonight. Tatum, and slammed up by Tatum.
And the ability to score in many ways. When Tatum drives with force, get out of his way.
Pass to Cunningham. And here is Howard. That's another rebound. He holds in his 20th rebound.
Dominating the glass.
Celtics leading by six. Here's Best. And the shot falls short this time.
High percentage look for him. But bottom line, they're not all going to go down.
Harden kicks to Sexton, shoots over Brown. Detroit, no good that time either. Inside, here's Obdia. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Damn,
Obdia, man. Lead up to eight now for the Celtics. Guys are looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Nice ball movement by Detroit. Pass to Howard. Now, here's Cunningham. Here's Harden. Off with the layup. Here's Best. He dishes it to Brown. And the pass to Tatum. Kicks it out to Allen. Brown outside. Six to shoot. Over Sexton. Again, the Celtics shoot the shoots.
And you gotta respect how accomplished Brown is now of destroying whoever is in his way.
I guess it's this year. This is their year, then. Fuck.
And Coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused. It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive. Come from beyond the arc, and that's been
exactly this nigga shooting threes and shit.
And his teammates, and without his work from downtown, their offense would have really struggled.
They're going to be the Eastern Conference champions because of the work he's done tonight. And you know what? If he manages to stay this hot in the finals, he's going to have his hands on that trophy in no time. This is it to Howard. Kicks it to Cunningham. Looking to end the run. That one drops for him. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Detroit making a switch. Charges checked in. Sideline. Let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. During the last break, got to listen in on Ime Udoka's huddle with his team. He put it on them. He said, guys, we've got a chance to win this one. And you've got a chance to close this team out. We can't let it go to waste. We'll see if they can seize the moment.
Thank you, David. Great communication on the alley-oop.
As Allen continues to develop his offensive game, he continues to earn the trust of his teammates.
Sexton dishes to Ayton. Cunningham passes to Ayton. Stolen by Allen. 1:25 left in the fourth quarter. And the wide open shot from Avdija. No good on the three.
It's hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. 10-point lead. This is their biggest.
And just not much more you can say, guys. It's the end of the line for one team in a hard fought the NBA Finals for Boston.
And the big difference here was accuracy from three-point range.
And once they started sinking shots, they really stretched out the D and created other opportunities. And anytime they got space, they seemed to just knock down another triple.
And what a performance they put on with their season on the line. Such enormous pressure heading into this Game 7. They were clearly saving their best for last.
Yeah, these conference finals were a battle for them all the way. But when they needed to be at their best, here tonight they were. And we'll see if having to go the distance in this series takes anything out of them heading into the final round.
Damn, man. Tatum finally beat me in the finals. And gang go beat me in the playoff series.
And he knocks down the first one. There's 48 seconds left in the fourth. And here's Young. Best passes to Allen. The kick out to Tatum. Good on the triple. Tatum's got the lead up to 13 now for the Celtics.
And it's just competing. And, you know, giving your best when it matters most. It's called killer instinct. It's one thing to be close at the end. It's another to finish.
Here's Best. 23 seconds left in the game. Pass to Tatum. To the inside. And slam dunk by Allen.
They just blocked out the noise, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
And guess what? It's going to be a fun flight home. Total team effort. Big win on the road.
Harden, and he gets the whistle.
And they're all over.
Took all the air out the damn building.
He misses the free throw. And he sinks the second. And so the Boston Celtics take the series and will continue.
And you can see the elation on their faces. Not just happiness, but pure
damn, game seven.
NBA Finals.
A tremendous opportunity. Now just four wins away from a championship.
Yeah, it's so close. I mean, they can practically taste it right now. But it's not going to be easy. Those next four wins are going to be the most difficult of the season if they can get them. But no matter what happens, I think the accomplishment of winning the conference championship is something this franchise and its fans will always remember.
And they'll represent the East in a final series that's mere days away. And so this one is in the books. We hope you've enjoyed being with us for the Eastern Conference Finals. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.
Big man is hitting threes. That wasn't a big man, but man, we ain't hitting threes. And my boy Adiani getting back to the finals. Best, he played really good. Tatum finally got on to the finals. Hopefully he can win it. Two rebounds. Blew a 3-2 lead. Damn. Three pointers, man. We only attempted five. Three pointers, man. Every time we keep getting outscored from the three, man, I couldn't do everything from the post, man, damn. Look at this shit. Look how many points we had that was in the paint. Two fucking threes. Man, almost twice as many point pace. The fuck, man? Damn, they lost in game seven.
L.
Who is this? Yeah, I took them to L's, man. Back-to-back L's, man. I blew a 3-2 lead in the conference finals. I blew a 3-2 lead in a freaking conference finals. That's wild. I won the MVP though. That's where I'm going, man.
T1C, what? Did you think I was gone forever? Stop spamming caps, warning.
And I got Defensive Player of the Year. MVP, Defensive Player of the Year. And we had Coach of the Year, too. And Marty guy made it damn first team All-NBA. He must be really good.
Night, but you know.
Two zero three zero
is crazy.
Yeah, it is, bro. Seven games, man. We want to find him MVP. Let's see what my team looking like. Oh, we got our guy. Yeah, big lineup now.
G.
We got Corey Benjamin, old school guy. Played together in Memphis. Cool, we got rid of the other dude with the fro.
Go feed your kids dirty nigga and pay the child support.
Guy.
What up, Wagwan? Is that guy in that life, baby? To the fear, smoke on. Smoke on, smoke on. He must be talking with me like that because he think I'm your daddy. I'm not your daddy. Little boy, I'm not your daddy. Little boy, I'm not your daddy. Smoke on, smoke on. Smoke on, smoke on. I want you to smoke on, smoke on. Ain't nobody texting my phone no more. Should smoke on, smoke on.
What? I want you to smoke on. Oh, let me get this thing right. I want you to smoke on, little nigga. Smoke on. Man, we lost the damn finals. Man, we lost the damn finals, bro. That's crazy as fuck. We lost the conference finals. And they lost the finals. Smoke up.